How do I print pictures from websites so that they look good? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Here's a question I get, actually, kind of often. I would like to know the simplest way to print a small to medium image from a web page and have it print out as a crisp picture to fit an 8.5 by 11 sheet. This question has one simple answer and one complicated answer. The simple answer is that most of the time, you can't. What you're asking for can't be done. The complex answer, of course, is it depends. I often get frustrated watching TV crime shows because I know too much, right? They frequently take liberties with what is and is not technologically actually possible. For example, the classic case. A bunch of detectives are looking at a blurry photo of a car in the distance, and the person in charge directs the resident computer guru to enhance it. Maybe even more than once. Enhance, enhance. Like magic, the blurry photo of the car in the distance gets crisper and crisper, the license plate becomes visible, the cops identify the criminal, and they save the day. It doesn't work that way. At least not the magical enhancement they're talking about. If a picture's blurry, it's blurry. If a picture has low resolution, it has low resolution. Yeah, there are enhancements of a sort, but they all involve trading off other aspects of the image, typically decreasing image fidelity in order to, say, increase contrast, change colors, and the like. Some of those enhancements will, in fact, reveal something. Sometimes they won't. No enhancement will take a small, blurry image and turn it into a large, crisp one. And that's exactly what you're asking for. So let's use an example. I've got a couple pictures here in the Pictures app, I think it is, in Windows 11. If I look at this one, you can see it's small-ish, right? This is something like 200 pixels wide. It measures approximately a couple of inches across, meaning that this screen is roughly about 100 dots per inch. Now, if I wanted to print that picture on an 8.5-inch wide piece of paper using 8 inches as the printable area, that means the printing process will need to make that picture 4 times wider and 4 times higher. Now, I can do that here in the Pictures app simply by saying, okay, give me 400%. Boom. But right away, you can see that he's blurry. Okay? There's nothing we can do to get around that. It's a blurry photo at this size. We're not done. Most printers print at resolutions of at least 300 dpi, if not much higher. The net effect is that if you print an image that is less than that, say our 100 dpi image, then the printer or your printing software must also magnify that image again. That's an additional factor of 3 times. I'm not sure that I can even zoom to the 1200% that this would take. I can't. This is 800%, which isn't even enough to print this full page. You can see. Puppy's blurry. And it's really, really noticeable when you make it larger. When you go back to 100%, looks pretty reasonable. The bottom line is that on-screen images rarely print in high fidelity. There's just no getting around the fact that you're magnifying a small on-screen image and printing it on a device with higher inherent resolution. Now, there is an exception, and it depends entirely on how the web page you're looking at was designed. And for reasons that become clear, most web pages are not designed this way. If you actually go to the companion article for this video, you'll see this same image on the page. I'm going to go ahead and look at it here. You can see this is actually a little bit bigger than the 200 pixel wide image, but you get the idea. This guy on the left, he looks crisper even now. And that's because even though it's not displaying in full size, there's a larger image behind this. Remember, when we did the small one, the original is actually smaller than what we were seeing on the screen. If we do this one, The original is bigger than what we were seeing in that original view. In fact, what we're looking at here is 69%. Let's go ahead and take that to 100% so that you can actually see the quality, the inherent quality of this image. Now, web pages can be designed to use a larger image like that, but display them in a smaller hole. So the image I'm looking at is a 1,153 pixel by 1,249 pixel image. But if you display it on a web page to display it in a 200 by 217 rectangle, well, it's going to be smaller. The image behind it is still the same size. The image behind it still has all the quality that you see here. Here's the problem. This image is bigger, and I don't mean that display-wise. I mean that the file size is larger. Most web pages are designed to be displayed quickly, which means they will typically try to use a smaller version of something that is appropriate for displaying on the web page instead of a larger version behind the scenes that could potentially be printed at higher resolution. All right. There is something that has changed dramatically since I originally wrote the first version of this article. And that is AI. You'll notice I added a third version of the image to the screen. Remember, here's our original low-resolution image. It is that small, and if we enhance it or increase it to 400%, it still looks blurry. If, on the other hand, I take a look at this other image that I've added, this is now AI-enhanced. I've used the tool Topaz Gigapixel and used it to enhance the size of this image by, I think, 6 times. It is not the same quality as the high resolution original. If we take a look at them side by side, the middle one is the high resolution original. To its right is the low resolution original that we would have used on a web page, and you can see that even at this size, it's blurry. The one on the left, however, is the AI enhanced version. It's not as crisp as the original full-sized, but it is better than the blurry one, and it was based on the blurry one. The difference is rather simple. Rather than just stretching and smoothing pixels to take up more space, which is what most zooms do, AI actually examines the content of the image and attempts to enhance it in ways that correspond to the content. For example, eyes are made larger in ways that make sense for eyes. Fur or hair is made larger, maintaining the characteristics of fur, and so on. You may find that this process could get you something that is better enough. It's never going to be the same quality as the high-resolution original, but if all you have is the low-resolution blurry photo, this could be good enough. Here's the catch. Even AI can't put information into a photo that isn't there. By that I mean, even AI can't reconstruct license plate numbers that aren't visible in the low-resolution original, no matter what the cop shows are showing you. At best, it'll make something up that comes close in appearance to a license plate, but potentially be completely, completely wrong. For high-resolution print to result in a sharp, clear image, you need to begin with a high-resolution image. There's just no way around that. Most web images are not high-resolution. While 200 pixels wide looks great on a screen, it's nowhere near enough high resolution for a high-quality print. Again, there is still no way to get around that. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/45996. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Still not AI-enhanced. Thanks for watching. Thank you.